Minnesota Deer Hunters Association's Hides for Habitat. William Hovey Smith, 2018. I'm the author of Backyard Deer Hunting, and not only do I hunt in my backyard, I sometimes go elsewhere. In this case, I was invited to the Minnesota Governor's Deer Opener in Hinckley, Minnesota, and I drove my Ford sports truck up there from Georgia. This is Hovey Smith, and I'm talking to Gary Thompson, the Senior Vice President of the Minnesota Deer Hunters Association. And we are going to talk about an unusual program, Hides for Habitat.
Yes, and thank you for talking with me on this. We established the Hides for Habitat program in 1985. Since then, we have collected hundreds of thousands of hides, and we sell them and have earned over $5 million by using those hides. That money goes back into habitat, enhancing habitat for the deer. And when you're enhancing habitat for deer, you're enhancing it for the grouse and the pheasant and everything else in the woods.
Yes, sir. Well, in Georgia, although most people don't know it, back in the 1600s, 1700s, and early 1800s, we exported millions of deer hides to Europe. That was one of the early export of the American colonies, was deer hides. Nowadays, hides are collected by taxidermists and sold to the Chinese, who make running shoes out of them, including some of the most expensive ones you can buy. So, if you're out there trotting around, you're running on American deer.
Yeah.
Now, Gary, how long have you been involved with the Deer Hunters Association?
I joined the Deer Hunters Association in 1989. I was alternate state director, I've been a chapter president, a regional director, and now the state vice president.
Tell me physically what happens to the hides as you turn them in. I noticed a filling station up the road that had a drop-off point at Sandstone, and what happens to them after you drop them off?
Okay. We go around every other day, pick up the hides. Some of the chapters salt them, some of them sell them green. We get hold of our buyers, they come down. If they're green hides, they'll come once, twice a week, whenever you need them to pick up those hides. Once they're all collected, then they are shipped overseas to China, and they're processed over there. Each year, it differs in price as far as how much we get per hide on.
Yes, sir. Now, that is a good and very excellent program for increasing habitat. Mm-hmm. So I'm very, very pleased to learn about it and hear that y'all are doing it. So thank you very much.
Well, thank you for having us on. Thank you.
Not only am I the author of Backyard Deer Hunting, I also have other prize-winning books, including Extreme Muzzle Loading, Crossbow Hunting, Practical Bow Fishing, and a series of inexpensive e-books on muzzleloading. And these include muzzleloaders for hunters, shooting and maintaining your muzzleloader, as well as hunting with muzzleloading shotguns and smoothbore muskets. My most recent book is a business book, Create Your Own Job Security. Plan to start your own business at midlife. What I advocate here is that a person start and run a whole series of businesses throughout their lives. Get used to the idea of being an entrepreneur. When you go to college, take some business courses. Look for like-minded individuals. Then actually start your own business. Get your trademark, get your patent started, and so on while you're living life, getting your health insurance and working for the man. Then, should you suddenly be laid off in your 40s and older and have very much difficulty in finding another job, you have your own business to fall back on. Now, this book is available from Amazon.com and many other sources. Using a deer hide collection program to improve wild game habitat is something can be done by any number of organizations at any scale in any state. Minnesota happens to have a very effective program. For more information on my books, blogs, and more than 700 videos, go to my website, www.hoveysmith.com. For more information on my business books, go to createyourownjobsecurity.com. Good hunting and good eating from the outdoors. Goodbye, and God bless.